Hi, everybody. It's Aaron from Solace, and this is how to get started with our Java samples. Okay, so head over to our Solace samples GitHub page at github.com/solacesamples, where you'll find a bunch of samples for different languages and different protocols that Solace supports. Click on the Solace samples Java and download the zip file. Now I'm on a Windows 10 laptop, so I have a bash shell that I quite like to use. So I'm just gonna go ahead and unzip that that right here in my downloads directory. So probably the best place to start would be the README file. You can either view it here or a little bit nicer formatted here on the GitHub page. The first thing you're gonna need is to make sure you have a Solace environment for your applications to connect into. So you can either click on this first link to head over to cloud.solace.com to sign up for a fully managed version of Solace in whichever cloud you want, or follow this link to head over to our downloads page to get a copy of the software broker that you can run on your laptop or on a server. And you can also find the Docker version of the software broker on Docker Hub. Okay, so there are some fairly detailed tutorials that walk through each of the different samples that are included, but I'm just gonna go ahead and build and run the samples. So the Java samples use Gradle as their build tool. If you're not familiar with Gradle, it's kind of like Ant and Maven combined. It's a build tool and a dependency manager. You don't need to download it or install it or anything. It's already kind of built in here with the samples. So I'm just gonna go ahead and run it here from the command line. The one prerequisite for Gradle is a Java JDK. You need to have a JDK installed. So make sure that you have that before you go ahead and try and build these. So if you're on a Mac or a Linux box, you'll be using the same kind of shell script style command here that I am in my bash shell. But if you're on a Windows machine and using the command prompt, it's slightly different. So dir, you're gonna be using the gradlew.bash file. Now, because Gradle is a Java application, you know, it's gonna run pretty much the exact same way, regardless of whether you're running it in a Windows style shell or in a Linux style shell. Either one, there we go. It goes ahead and builds the samples for us. Next step is to run the samples, and you can see that everything is kind of deployed into this build/stage directory. So go ahead and check that out, bin. And you can see that Gradle builds all the script files required to run all the different samples. I'm gonna go ahead and run the topic subscriber first. And it's looking for some connection information, the host, username, password, that kind of stuff. So if you've downloaded a default instance of the Solace software broker, everything is, you know, this would be localhost and this would be kind of default. But if you're running in Solace Cloud and you don't really know where to find your connection information, that's all right. Click on one of the tutorials. It kind of describes what the different parameters are that you're gonna need and shows you in Solace Cloud where they are. In the console, you'll click on the Connect tab, then Solace Messaging for the API, and all of the connection details are there on the right-hand side. And it also kind of reminds you, if you have the software version, what values to be using for that. So let's go ahead and run that. Localhost, and then default at default, password not required. That's gonna go ahead and run, and my topic subscriber is now connected and awaiting a message. So what does that mean? I have some slides here that can kind of explain it. So the topic publisher subscriber example is actually in two parts. We've just run the topic subscriber, simple little Java application. All it does is subscribe to Solace, connect to Solace, and then we'll subscribe with a non-persistent topic subscription to this topic here, tutorial/topic, and then sits there waiting for a message to arrive on that particular topic. Next, we're gonna run the topic publisher, another application, very similar. It's also gonna connect to Solace. It's going to publish a single direct or a non-persistent message onto the corresponding topic, tutorial/topic, and then disconnect. The topic subscriber, since he's already online and subscribed, will receive that one message and then also disconnect. So a very simple little hello world pub sub, one message in, one message out example. So since my subscriber is still connected here, let's go ahead and run the publisher. I'm gonna run it in the command prompt shell. So it's gonna be /stage /bin/topic publisher.bat and asking for the same connection parameters. So localhost, come on. And username doesn't matter for the default bin and no password required. Topic publisher initializing. And there we go. It has published a message with the content Hello World on this topic, tutorial/topic. And you can see over here on the console for my topic subscriber that indeed it did receive the message on that topic with the delivery mode of direct, and there's the payload of Hello World. All right, Hello World done with PubSub. I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, make sure you check out my next video where I'm going to dig into the code a little bit, and I'm also going to walk through some of the other samples that are included. Thanks.